Hi everyone, today we are going to see class 12 applications of matrices and determinants exercise 1.1 problem number 2 and this is video number 3. Before going to the exercise we need to know what is inverse of a matrix A. Okay, how to find that whether it exists or not. There is a method for that. Let me explain you clearly. First we have to find the determinant value of A. Okay. If it is not equal to 0, then inverse of A exists. Okay? So, if we find the determinant value and if it is not equal to 0, then we can confirm that inverse of A is possible and we can find that. Okay? There is a formula to find A inverse. That is, A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A. Okay? Let me explain you the steps to find the inverse of A. First, we have to find the determinant value of A. Okay? If it is not equal to 0, we can confirm that A inverse exists and we can continue the process. The second step is that we have to find the cofactor of A. Okay? The third step is to find the adjoint of A. How can you find an adjoint of A? It is just the transverse of the cofactor. That is, in cofactor, all the rows must be converted into columns. It will be the adjoint A. Okay? Now we can find the A inverse by using the formula. A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. Clear? If we go into the problem, we can understand it better. Okay? This is a 3 cross 3 matrix. We have to find the inverse of this matrix. We can name this matrix as A. Okay? The first step is to find the determinant value of A. How can we find that? 5 into, where is this 5? It is in row 1 and column 1. Leaving that, we get 5, 1, 1, 5. Okay? Minus, the second number in the row 1 is 1. Into, the 1 is in second column, first row, isn't it? So, leaving the 5 elements, we get 1, 1, 1, 5. Okay? So, 1 into 1, 1, 1, 5. Plus, the third element in the row 1, 1. Okay? On leaving the row 1 and column 3, we get 1, 5, 1, 1. Okay? 1 into 1, 5, 1, 1. Okay? Now, we can continue with the calculation. 5 into cross multiply. 5 into 5, 25. Minus 1 into 1, 1. Minus 1 into 1 into 5, 5. Minus 1 into 1, 1. Clear? Plus 1 into 1 into 1, 1. Cross multiply, okay? Minus 1 into 5, 5. Now, 5 into 25 minus 1 is equal to 24. Minus 1 into 5 minus 1 is 4. Plus 1 into minus 4. Okay, 1 minus 5 is minus 4. 5 into 24 is 120. Minus 1 into 4 is minus 4. Plus 1 into minus 4 is also minus 4. So, 120 minus 8, which is equal to 112. And it is definitely not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Okay? Determinant A is equal to 112. And it's not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Clear? Okay. Now we have found the determinant value of A, which is equal to 112. Now we have to find cofactor of A. Okay. Now listen to me carefully. Now we are going to find the cofactor of A. Now there is a sign convention to find the 3 cross 3 matrix cofactor. Plus minus plus, minus plus minus, and again plus minus plus. Okay. Now we can find the cofactor of the first element in row 1, 5. Okay, where is 5? It is in row 1 and column 3, column 1. I'm going to hide it. We have to eliminate it and we have to write the remaining elements 5, 1, 1, 5. So, what is the sign convention for that place? Plus. plus 5115. Okay. The second place ion conformation is minus. And where is that one? It is in column 2 and row 1. Leaving that, we get 1115. So minus of 1115. Clear? Now the sign convention for the next place is plus, and where is that one? It is in row 1, column 3. On eliminating the elements, we get 1511. So plus of 1511. Now we have to find the cofactor of second place, and the sign convention is minus, and where is that one? It is in row 2 and column 1. Now I am hiding the elements and we get 1115. So minus of 1115. What is the sign convention for the next place? Plus. Where is that 5? Is that the place 5? Yes, it is in row 2 and column 2. So remaining the elements are 5115. Plus of 5115. The next place sign convention is minus, and where is that one? It is in row 2 and column 3. On hiding these elements, we get 5111. Clear? Now we have to find the cofactor of next place, and the sign convention for that place is plus. So where is that one? It is in row 3, column 1. On hiding the elements, we get 1151. Okay? Now the sign convention for the next place is minus. So minus of, where is that one? It is in row 3 and it is in column 2. Okay? On hiding the element, we get 5111. Okay? Now the sign convention for the next place is plus, and where is it 5? It is in row 3 and column 3. Okay? So what are the remaining elements? 5115. Isn't it? So we have found the cofactor of the 3 cross 3 matrix. Now we have to find the calculation. So plus of cross multiply, 5 into 5, 25, minus 1 into 1, minus 1. Okay? Minus, the sign convention minus, cross multiply, 1 into 5, 5, minus 1 into 1, 1. Okay? Plus, cross multiply, 1 into 1, 1. Minus 1 to 5, 5. Clear? Now second place, second row, minus of 1 into 5, 5. Minus 1 into 1, 1. Plus of 5 into 5, 25. Minus 1 into 1, 1. Okay? Minus of, next element, minus of 5 into 1, 5. Minus 1 into 1, 1. Okay? Next element, plus of 1 into 1, 1, minus 5 into 1, 5. Next element, minus of 5 into 1, 5, minus 1 into 1, 1. Clear? The last element, plus of 5 into 5, 25, minus 1 into 1, 1. Okay? Now let's do the final calculation. 25 minus 1 is plus 24. 5 minus 1 is 4, minus of 5 minus 1 is minus 4. 1 minus 5 is minus 4. Minus of 5 minus 1 is minus 4. 25 minus 1 is 24. Minus of 5 minus 1 is minus 4. Plus of 1 minus 5 is minus 4. Minus of 5 minus 1 is minus 4. 25 minus 1 is 24. Clear? Now this is cofactor of A. Now we have to find the adjoint A by using this cofactor. Clear? How to find that? Adjoint of A is nothing but transfers of cofactor of A. Isn't it? That is, the row 1 in cofactor A will become the column 1 in adjoint A. The row 2 in column in cofactor A will become a column 2 in adjoint A. The row 3 in cofactor A will become the column 3 in adjoint A. Clear? Now I am making the row 1 into column 1. 24 minus 4 minus 4 into column 1. The row 2 minus 4, 24 minus 4 into column 2. Okay? Minus 4, 24 and minus 4. I am making row 3 minus 4 minus 4, 24 into column 3. -4, -4, 24. What is this? This is the transpose of cofactor of A, which is the adjoint of A. Now we know determinant value and adjoint value. Then it is easy for us to calculate the inverse of A. What is A inverse? 1 by determinant A into adjoint A, isn't it? Therefore, 1 by what is determinant value? 112, that is 112 into what is the 3 cross 3 matrix adjoint A? 24, -4, -4, -4, -4, -4, -4, 24. Okay? -4, -4, 24. Now, from the matrix we can clearly see that 4 is common in all the elements in the matrix, right? So, I am going to take 4 out of this. So, 4 by 112 into 24, when 4 is taken out, it gives 6. -1, -1, -1, 6, -1, -1, -1, 6. Clear? When we divide 4 and 112, we get 1 by 28. Therefore, A inverse is equal to 1 by 28 into 6, -1, -1, -1, 6, -1, -1, -1, 6. Clear? What is this? This is the A inverse and we have found the A inverse. Clear? Do you have any doubts? Okay, so with this, exercise 1.1, problem 2 is over. If you have any doubts, please comment down and I will clear it for you. Okay? Meet you all in the next video. Till then, signing off, Parveena Ramesh. Bye-bye.
Yes.